So we're thrilled to have Dr. Yuri Cronin. He's really just a leader in the field of subtle energy research, and he's just really bringing this out to the world in a fantastic way, really solidly researched. And also want to let you know that he's done an online course, right, for Quantum University. I linked to that course on our Facebook page, if you ever go to our Facebook page, but you can go to Quantum University if you want to kind of follow some of this online teaching as well. So please join me in welcoming Dr. Yuri Cronin.
Thank you. Do you hear me well?
Yeah.
And you hear my Russian accent? You know, when I just came to the United States, a friend of mine, lawyer from New Jersey, he said, "Don't lose your Russian accent. Americans like it." And tell them your stories. They are very interesting. So I'm today telling you my story with Russian accent. So we will be talking about subtle energy. And probably you know that this is energy. It's kind of modern name for very old force of the universe, which ancient knew about. And they called it life force. Life force is a very strong name, right? It means that it influences everything living. And it means that it is vitally important for our life. But our science doesn't recognize the existence of subtle energy and actually doesn't want to research it. Why? We will talk a little bit later about it. But mainly because subtle energy cannot be directly measured by existing scientific equipment. And we have here a big gap between what ancient knew and thought about this force and what modern science thinks. So modern science actually thinks that it doesn't exist. But ancient considered this force main force of the universe, which actually runs everything in the universe and is the main supporter, if you wish, of all life. So that's what Lao Tzu, which you definitely know about, what he said 2,500 years ago about energy. There are numberless energy rays in the universe. All rays come from the subtle nature of the universe, which means that we have more subtle part of the universe than physical, which we know. And the interwoven energy net influences the lives of individual human beings, whole societies, and entire races. A virtuous individual who responds to the high, pure, harmonious subtle energy rays and integrates them with the positive elements of his own being may strengthen his life, enhance his health and power, and lengthen his years. So it's a very strong statement. And you can see that if we would say this statement in modern scientific language, we would say that subtle energy is actually software of the whole life on all levels, starting from individuals and ending with the whole societies and races. So this huge gap between understanding of ancients and modern science should be somehow bridged. Otherwise, we will be in this position, as I always say to my students of Quantum University, our society reminds me fish school. And this fish school lives in water, research water, knows about water very well, but it doesn't know that it is alive because it breathes oxygen, which is much subtler, gaseous substance, which is dissolved in the water. We are in some sense like this school of fish, which doesn't know what runs this life. And Right now, there is a lot of research done not by mainstream scientists, but so-called, very often called, alternative science or frontier scientists. And there is a book written about it. I don't know how many of you know about this book. Claude spoke here. Okay. There's a lot of research collected in this book, 700-page book. Claude collected a lot of research in this book. And there is no doubt that there is such a force as called now by frontier science, subtle energy. But there is one but here. When you try to understand, so what it is, from modern scientific point of view, okay, we know that something exists. It influences physical substance and living organism, but what it is? If you go to, let's say, Google, and Google knows everything, as you know, and ask about subtle energy, you will see a lot of different interpretations of what it is. And you will find these kind of words like, this is scalar waves, or this is bioplasma, or this is torsion fields. So question is it something different? It's some kind of many different energies exist. And what is interesting that all presenters of these theories actually are saying that this force is byproduct of forces which we already know, like electrical, like this scalar wave. What is it? It is the same electrical field, but it is scalar. It's not, vibrating in this direction. It's vibrating in this direction. Other than that, and immediately a lot of questions can be asked. Okay, if it's still electromagnetic field, but different kind of electromagnetic field, it's still produced by electrical charges, electrically charged particles. So why cannot we measure it? And you can ask many questions about any of these theories, like torsion fields. Okay. Ancients knew that this life force, qi, Chinese call them, prana, Indians call them, have many properties which are very different from electromagnetic field properties. For instance, many of you probably know about acupuncture, of course, right? And if you ask acupuncturist about properties of qi, he or she will tell you immediately that it has five elemental properties. There is qi with qualities of water, quality of metal, quality of fire, quality of earth, and none, and wood, right? And none of these theories explain how come these properties exist, where they are coming from. All these theories, in other words, these theories don't explain very important property of this energy, which really makes it different from electromagnetic energy. Now, what Claude Swanson says about it in this, he says that scientific revolution is underway, and the effect of the life force are being demonstrated, documented, and measured. It is like no other force known to science. It is intimately involved with life processes. It plays a central role in growth and healing. It does not weaken with distance and penetrates most materials and shielding. In many ancient cultures, manipulation of this energy is one of the central arts of medicine. Tomorrow, I'm doing workshop tomorrow, and I will go in some details how we can explain, but at least prove and understand, at least qualitatively, why and how it is not diminished with the distance. But there is a lot of proof that this energy has these unusual properties which are different from any energy known to the science. What he says, Claude Swanson, about difficulties to research this energy. He says it manifests itself in many ways. Usually scientists examines only one aspect of it at a time. Therefore, most scientists who investigate it only see part of the picture. Their description is reminiscent of the fable of the sixth blind man and the elephant. One man feels its tail and concludes it was a rope, another felt its leg and described it as a tree, and third felt it its ear and described as a large leaf, while a fourth touched its side and described it as a wall. It's really true, and even more than that, when our scientists decided to investigate so-called dark matter and dark energy, which we will be talking about pretty soon, they found that our equipment, the same equipment, shows different results with the same conditions they consider for detecting parts of this so-called dark matter. What is that? Why it is so different? Why it manifests it in so different ways? To understand how it works, we need at least have some ideas about how it interacts with physical matter. If we don't have any hypothesis even or about how it interacts with physical matter, then we, of course, cannot explain how it influences it, and we cannot explain how it influences human being. So we need at least to have some consistent point of view on how it interacts with physical matter and also with living matter. And what is interesting, that it's not that there is no scientific results with subtle energy. If you will talk to some medical doctor, let's say, and he or she will definitely, I spoke with dozens of them, and they say, there is no any scientific proof that it exists. And there is no scientific proof that it can do something serious to physical matter. But in China, in the Institute of High Energy Physics, there were experiments done starting from 1970s. And these experiments were done with the help of Qigong masters. His name is Dr. Yang Xin. He is a medical doctor. I don't know how many of you heard about these experiments. Beverly definitely knows about it, but not many people. Why? Because nobody speaks about it. If you again go to the Google, which knows everything, it hardly will show you this book. Because in our society, which believes in science, everybody wants scientific proof. And if there is no scientific proof, so-called scientific proof, nobody pays attention to these results. But this is scientific proof, because they did these experiments using absolutely scientifically very well-known equipment and showed that it changes, as Claude Swanson says, even radioactive decay rate. Can you imagine what it is? The human being can project some energy which changes radioactive decay rate. Radioactive decay rate is due to certain force of the universe. It's called weak force. It's one of the four fundamental forces of the universe. And according to our science, nothing can change this force. And no, none of these four forces. And suddenly, human being can change this force. And what he did in these experiments, he was able to increase or decrease rate of decay, radioactive decay, with his mind, which means that this force, think about this, this fundamental force can be changed by another force, which means that this force is more powerful than forces existing according to our science in nature. And on top of it, this so powerful force can be directed by human mind. It totally changes the whole view of the universe. Right? And nevertheless, you will not find any response of our science on this topic, like it never happened. And bunch of articles were published about this. And but mainly when you speak to our scientists, they say, you know, these ancients, what they knew about these forces of the universe? We have equipment, we are measuring them, we know they didn't. But ancient knew something. For instance, you know about this stone of southern Lebanon, probably. Who? Huh? Hmm? Yes, in Baalbek, right. See, this stone, which was precisely cut and moved, and it's 120 tons weight stone. How they moved it? How they worked with this? Nobody knows. So they knew something, and we need to pay attention to what ancient people says, and using modern science, trying to bridge this knowledge of ancients with what we can do with our technologies. That's what I started. Stop. A little bit. Mm-hmm. Don't. Yeah. No. Let's talk about this a little bit first, and then show that. Why that findings which Chinese have with this subtle energy is important? Because what actually how ancients presented picture of the universe. They said that, you know probably this picture, that universe consists not only from physical substance. It has also more subtle substance. They call it etheric. You know this name, right? And even there is a more subtle substance and world, which is, they called it astral world. And there is a more subtle world, which is mental world, and so on. And they called even spiritual world exists, and this spiritual world is the source of everything which is below. Every world is created by previous, more subtle world. And finally, it comes to our physical substance and our physical world and all these periodic table elements which make all substance of our physical body, right? And is there anything in findings of our modern science which indicates that this concept is true? And you probably know that pretty recently our science found so-called dark matter. How many of you heard this word? Yeah, dark matter and dark energy. And why why it is dark? Why they call it dark? One friend of mine said, no, because they are blind, and for blind everything is dark. So dark matter and dark energy. And what is it? Nobody knows. It's something which can be detected only because of measuring of movement of galaxy clusters. And it indicates that there is a substance in the universe which is more subtle, and they suppose, scientists suppose, that it consists of some undiscovered subatomic particles. And there is some energy which acts in that world, which is so powerful that it moves galaxies apart. And they call it, of course, also dark energy. And together, dark energy and dark matter occupy 96% of the universe. So it means that we, physical beings, occupy, and all our galaxies and billions of galaxies and billions of stars occupy only this 4% of the universe. So it pretty much resonates with what ancients were saying us about structure of the world. There is a very different, more subtle substance, which is pre-physical. It creates somehow physical world. And all substance of our world and all forces acting in this world is kind of byproduct of this 96% of the universe. And tomorrow, I don't have time about this today because it's a pretty long conversation, but there is a data received with not modern scientific equipment, but with human instrument, as I call it, received by very sensitive, specifically trained people who 100 years before our science discovered this phenomenon, we're investigating how physical matter is made. And they found everything which our science know today about existence of proton neutron, about all existence of quarks and even subquarks, which our science only suppose now that they exist. It's a long story, but I will talk about it tomorrow a little bit more, because this very interesting story showing how, if you combine modern knowledge with these abilities of human instrument to investigate structure of the universe, what results can be received. If our science would go in this way in the beginning of last century and combine these new technologies with existing already and functioning for thousands of years human instruments, results of our science would be absolutely different today. Now, of course, this is 96% of the universe right here. We are part of the cosmos, right? And science would supposedly should be asking questions how this 96% of the universe, more subtle, influences us, our health, and does it have something to do with ancient, you know, concept of life force and so on. But you cannot find these discussions in our scientific literature. So that is just saying that anomalies that cannot be explained by modern science suggest that existence of energy unknown to science. The discovery that dark matter and dark energy together occupy 96% of the whole universe leaves no doubt that some immeasurable energy acts throughout the whole universe, while electromagnetic energy acts only in the atomic part of it, which makes up only 4% of the whole. So let me tell you a little bit story about how I got involved in this, and that's what 30 years ago I decided to work on. I was a regular physicist. I was born and educated in Soviet Union, and you know that Soviet concept of the universe was simple. Matter is the only base of everything existing in the universe, and consciousness is byproduct of matter. So it was purely materialistic concept, of course. I was sharing this concept and never thought and believed in the existence of this kind of life force. Of course, I heard something that these Chinese said something about kind of chi, what does it mean, who knows. And probably superstition. And I had, as I said, my career in the area of physics is so-called nonlinear interaction of laser light with matter, and I was very successful in my career. I defended PhD dissertation, then I defended doctor's dissertation. System in Russia a little bit different, and in the whole Europe they have another level after PhD, which is called Doctor of Science. So I was preparing to defend this doctor's dissertation when I found out that in our institute, Institute of Radiotechnics and Electronics of Academy of Sciences, they investigate so-called psychic ladies, two psychic ladies. And very secretly, of course, nobody would know about it. But fortunately, my friend was involved in this research, and he gradually involved me in that research. And to my surprise, I saw absolutely amazing things. These two ladies, one of them was Ninel Kulagina. Probably somebody of you heard this name. Yeah, then Chinese made movie about her, like 6 hours movie. She did absolutely unexplainable things. Like, for instance, they took laser crystal, artificial laser crystal, ruby crystal, this big, like 20 plus centimeters, and propagated ultrasound through it. Nina brought her hands to this crystal, and sound disappeared. Of course, we thought immediately that something wrong with the generator of ultrasound. Of course, it's not possible. So I checked generator, everything works fine. Receiver works fine. In 2 minutes, this signal on the oscilloscope appeared again. She brought her hands towards crystals again, towards this crystal, and sounds disappeared again. You know, after that, I couldn't sleep a night. Yeah, because I thought, I'm not kidding. I thought, how can it be? You know, how you can explain with all this physics this phenomenon? You cannot. Ruby crystal is second hard material in the world after diamond, right? And something changes processes, like simple process, propagation of sound in this crystal, so that it couldn't propagate. What happened? Then, and of course, these scientists did all the measurements around, you know, magnetic field, electrical field. Yes, it's slightly different than from other people, but nothing which could explain this kind of phenomena. And they said, you know, she probably radiates ultrasound. Okay, fine. She radiates ultrasound. I said, guys, it's easy to find out. You put 2 microphones, ask her to direct ultrasound, and if, you know, delay between signals from first microphone and second will correspond to sound, speed of sound propagation in the air, you're true, you're right. So they did this experiment, and what happened? Nina could influence second first and first microphone second, or simultaneously, with any kind of delay between them. And when she got tired of all these scientists. You know, she put so much energy that destroyed one of these microphones. So there was no explanation how she does all of this. But second woman who was involved in this research, her name was Rosa Kuleshova. I don't know. She was not so, even later, she was not so famous as Nina. And probably even Beverly didn't hear about her, right? Yeah. She had different talent. You could take any text, put, let's say, metal on this text. She put her hands on this metal and reads what is under that. That was even more shocking for me because it means that that immeasurable energy not only can stop sound in the crystal, but it also somehow brings information to your body. And human being is capable to decode this information and read the text. And academician who was involved in this research, Yuri Borisovich Kobzarev, published article about it. He was so brave guy. He published article. Of course, they jumped on him. You can imagine how. Oh, he is crazy. This woman cheats them, this stupid scientist, and they cannot catch her. Okay. He was very angry. He was academician having Stalin prizes, like internal Nobel Prize in Russia, for radars, developing radars in the beginning of Second World War. And another article was published against him, of course, which said that, I don't know how, but of course she cheats them, and this nonsense. So Yuri Borisovich Kobzarev called this guy, called this another academician, Boravik Romanov was his name, and insisted that he would come and participate in this experiment. So they invited Rosa, and I was not at this experiment, but Yuri Borisovich personally told me about results of this experiment. She was sitting on a chair. They put cloth on her eyes and wrapped it with cheesecloth, I believe it's called in English, and put screen in front of her so that she couldn't see for sure, and asked this Boravik Romanov, academician, put his hands on her eyes so that he would be absolutely sure she cannot see anything. And Rosa was very angry because, you know, they said, and this Boravik Romanov said that she is, you know, is a cheater and dishonest woman and so on and so on. So she was sitting and Yuri Borisovich took book from the shelf, put it on the floor, opened it, and said, Rosa, let me take your shoe off. Rosa said, I can sit on your book and read it with my butt. I don't care. So she put her foot in a shoe on this book and read it. It was recorded. And then this Boravik Romanov personally read this and look in the book. He became really pale. Yuri Borisovich said, drop this book, turn around and run away. And he never spoke about it. And never anybody heard about him, from him, about participation in this experiment. That's how scientists usually react on this phenomenon. So, but for me, it was one practical question which I wanted to resolve. I wanted to understand how it is possible to harness this energy. If it exists in the universe, there should be a way to harness it. There should be a way to somehow, you know, use it practically. With the help of our new technology. Can we combine this ancient knowledge with modern technology? And I start working on it. It's a long, long, long story. I missed several dozens of years. And as a result, was I found out how to do it. So, first of all, I decided that this chi or subtle energy, whatever you call it, belongs and acts in the subatomic world. It is a world of substances, of particles which make our physical matter. I will be talking about it more tomorrow, but how it helped me, I understood that, you know, you need to take the most subtle substance existing in this physical world. And what is that? It is plasma. Plasma, you know, in all these bulbs, you have plasma discharge. When you create electrical discharge in a gas, it creates plasma, mixture of electrons and ions. It's the most subtle substance which you can have in this physical world. Yeah, that's what I forgot to tell you, that conclusion was, so that this, if energy medicine exists, it uses that universal energy which belongs to the subatomic world. And that is very important to understand. If we understand that it's so, we need to find out how this energy interacts with our physical world. Let's go further. And not only me, of course, thought about this energy and more subtle substance and the ability of human instrument to interact with that energy and substance. And there is a physicist in England whose name is Stephen Phillips. I don't know, Beverly knows about him probably. No? Oh, I would recommend you. You're probably the only one in this auditorium who is not afraid of physics. And it's absolutely necessary to read. It's an incredible book. It considers how human instruments is ESP, extrasensory perception, of quarks and superstrings, and how this human instrument can understand what this 96% of the universe is doing to our physical world, how it creates physical matter, and all consequences of this creation. It is an incredible book. So that time, of course, I didn't know about this book. It was not written that time. I did my own research. It what I understood that, okay, we have some energy. Now we call it subtle energy. Chinese call it qi. It interacts somehow with these subatomic particles. It doesn't interact directly with our atomic matter, with our physical matter. Otherwise, we could measure it. There is no also interaction between electromagnetic energy and these subatomic particles, direct interaction. Otherwise, these kind of things, it's already later came, of course, but otherwise we would be able to measure this dark matter. So what we can do, we can somehow manipulate this physical matter, plasma, to affect movement of these subatomic particles, and then we will somehow create disturbance in subtle energy field. And we can try to use this. So what I did, no, no, this is mine, my own stuff. What our science says, if you heard about so-called superstring theory, you probably know that what our science says, that this world where subatomic particles exist is more than three-dimensional. To explain all properties of these superstrings and how it creates particles of our world, they should suppose that world is at least 10-dimensional. And can you imagine if this energy acts in multi-dimensional world, how it projects its effect on our physical world can be so sophisticated and so difficult to explain in regular terms that it looks like some, I know, miracle. Now, but let's go to practical side and at least what we can do with modern technology to somehow harness at least partly this energy and what can be achieved to get some practical applications of this subtle energy in modern world. So what I did, I found that if I take plasma and start vibrating this plasma with different frequencies, it radiates some subtle energy along with electromagnetic energy. How we knew that? Dr. Igor Nazarov, who is here and came to help me, we know each other for 35 years. That time we belonged to the same group which investigated this phenomenon, and we wanted to feel this energy because we cannot measure it. So we went to a psychic person who trained us how to feel this energy, and we felt it. As soon as this plasma generator was created, I felt that it works. I switched on, oh yes, it works. And we will demonstrate you some energies today. I hope you will feel it too. So, what I found, that if you change content of plasma and use the same frequency of vibration, energy is absolutely different, which really corresponds to what we were talking about. This energy depends on what substance radiates this energy. Each substance has its own energy pattern. I will be talking about it is possible to explain and even suggest hypotheses why it is so. And I will be talking about it more tomorrow. But it's obvious that in ancient news that, you know, different stones have different energy. Different gemstones were used for healing. How they heal? Of course, with the energy which belongs to the stone. It means that each stone has different energy. Every substance has its own energetic patterns. So, making this story short, I just want to tell you that I found a way how to generate and create different energy patterns. And, for instance, I could generate with my generator energy of any periodic table elements. And how I am doing this? I am taking frequencies, subharmonics of frequencies, corresponding to electronic transition in this periodic table element, put it on my generator. And strangely enough, energy which is coming from there makes the same physiological effect as periodic table element itself. For instance, you know that lithium is very much used in modern medicine as antidepressant, right? But you know that lithium is chemically poison. It damage your liver, and people have terrible consequences of using. Yes, along with positive effect, which is antidepressant effect. But when I made energy of lithium, it appeared that it works exactly like lithium. It helps with depression. It helps with bipolar diseases. But it doesn't have any side effects because there is no chemical lithium. So this way, you can create a lot of things which can be used in much bigger amounts, like lithium. Lithium, you can use only micro dosage. You can use as much energy of lithium as you want without any side effects. The same with any other. Chromium helps to digest sugar. Vanadium also helps with sugar digestion. Or oxygen. We all need oxygen. It appears that if you make energy of oxygen and take energy of this oxygen, I will tell you how you can take energy of this oxygen. It increases oxygenation in the blood. So we found a lot of effects with the help of doctors, of course. And what we also found? We also found how not only to generate these energetic patterns, but put it in some storage. We found how to store them, then reproduce them, and infuse into any substance you wish. And for instance, we are using this kind of concentrated trace minerals. These concentrated trace minerals actually is like CD on which you record the music. You can have the same CD and record many, many different musics, songs on this CD. The same with minerals. If you infuse them with different energetic patterns, they will keep them for years. Why? Again, I don't have time to discuss it today. We'll be talking about it tomorrow more. But this experimental fact, when you infuse them, 10 years ago, we have bottles infused 10 years ago, and they still have energy. It's like CD, as I said. Now, I found that it is possible to generate, remember we talked about five elemental properties of these energies? I found how to generate energies with any of five elemental properties. I know how to generate wood energy, fire energy, and so on. How we checked it? On human being, of course. Human beings have acupuncture meridians, right? And these acupuncture meridians have these elemental properties, like heart meridian is fire property, liver meridian is wood property. So what we did, when I created this system of producing five elemental energies, we infused them in these minerals without any indication, gave it to doctors who use electroacupuncture and said, what this energy influences? And they measure, say, oh, you know, it influences heart. Uh-huh. Means that it's fire property, right? Okay, this influences liver. Oh, it means that it's wood property, right? So we did these experiments and we found that our way of generation five elemental energies are exactly right. Then, next step would be, okay, Chinese developed enormous amount of formulas how to use herbs, for instance, of different elemental properties, combining them with each other and creating remedies for digestion, heart support, liver cleansing, and so on and so on. So we start doing the same thing. We infuse these energies into minerals, mix them in certain proportions, send it to doctors and say, what it influences? Oh, my goodness, it influences digestion very well. Okay. So it means that this formula, which is called cauldron in Chinese literature, really works not only with herbs, it works also with this energy. So we used traditional Chinese medicine formulas for creating different energetic remedies. What some of formulas which were found were purely experimental findings without any theories. Suddenly we found, for instance, if we sweep frequencies of vibration of this plasma in certain range, with certain speed, we have energy which is wonderful for balancing sympathetic, parasympathetic nervous system. How we found it out? Use heart rate variability. There is a device which is even, approved by FDA, which measuring your heart rate and statistics of your heart rate can determine how balanced sympathetic parasympathetic response is. So we found, and what is interesting, you change on 1 hertz this vibration, it doesn't work. You change on 1 second speed of, and it doesn't work. So there are some very, very, I would say, fine features of this energy which you need to have certain effect, which means that information which you assign to this energy should be very precise. And then you have clear, perfect effect of the subtle energy on certain functions of physical body. Now, of course, we found also how to copy energies of existing substances. And we start copying, for instance, energies of precious stones. You cannot believe, it was a very interesting story. I came to a museum in one small town, which is called the Central Point in Oregon, just 20 minutes from us. And I saw amazing stones. 1 million years before he died, and he collected precious stones all over the world, donated this collection to this museum. And I came and saw a man standing there. I said, you know, I'm a physicist. I am working with subtle energy. I know that these stones have energy patterns which are very healing. I can copy them. How can I do it? Who can allow me to do it? He said, me. He was director of this museum. And he allowed me to do it, and I have energies of like $300,000 stone. Can you imagine? This big. And emerald, which is this big. Incredible. And these energies are very healing. So combining all these energy patterns, it is possible to create more and more and more sophisticated formulas, which we are doing already for many years, and we have right now over 5,000 different formulas, and only 50 of them we are selling to medical professionals because we need to investigate them first, how they work, and be sure that they do that job. And unfortunately, we don't have resources for making $1 million clinical studies. So, and what finally, we were talking about human mind working with these energies, capability of human mind to work with these energies. So, we decided, if so, people say that prayer has healing properties, right? Let's record the energy of prayer. Why not? We asked one rabbi from Jerusalem who was open to this, and we said, can you please pronounce prayer to this bottle? And he did it. We put this bottle in the equipment, made a copy of this energy, and it was absolutely incredible. And we even asked him to make, to pronounce a prayer which he, which Jewish people pronounce after a meal, having a meal. And we gave it to one psychic person without saying what it is and said, you know, Laura, take this bottle and tell me what this energy does to you. She took it, and in 1 second, she said, oh my goodness, it goes right here. It helps me to digest food, and it spreads the energy of this food all over the body. This was energy of prayer after you have food. So we start recording energies of prayers, energies of healers, Again, if healer does some healing and we ask him to use these, you know, minerals during healing, then we take these minerals, put in the equipment, make a copy of it, and we have this energy forever. So again, combining all this stuff, we can create absolutely amazing formulas to affect practically anything you can imagine. So we start doing, of course, we wanted to do scientific research, scientific experiment to prove these stubborn scientists that it really not only exists, but it really works. So finally, we found here and there some open-minded scientists and did some real scientific research, which I will talk more tomorrow, but today I will just make brief observation of what we did. First of all, you know about work of Emoto. Do we have Emoto? Book? It's not here? It disappeared? Okay. Well, you know about work of Emoto. Everybody knows it. Yeah? You say, you know, I like you, I like you, I like you, and you have wonderful crystal created from water you speak to. And then you say you're an idiot and you have this chaotic crystal and so on. And if you say thank you, it's wonderful crystal again and so on. And if you thank you and you are an idiot, you have mixture of some structure with chaos. So we decided, okay, let's take our energies, infuse them and do the same as Emoto did. And we had the different energy patterns create different structure of water crystals. Well, that was just the beginning, of course. It's not very scientific. But then we did some research, for instance, on cell phone radiation. Cell phone radiation impacts our brain waves. And there is a lot of research now showing that actually it's harmful. So we decided, can we create some energy pattern which, being put on your phone, helps your brain to overcome this negative influence? And we found this pattern. And this is a result, for instance. This frontal lobe is overexcited in this area when person is talking on the phone. If he or she is talking on the same phone, same amount of time, but with energy attached, and we infused in it just plastic. It put plastic on the phone. And you don't have this overexcitement here. And it's already scientific because it's brain mapping. It's accepted by modern science research. Now, we start doing with the help of Lefty Levengood. You probably knew him, Beverly. Lefty Levengood? Yeah, you know him. He was great scientist, and he did a lot of research. He passed away recently. And he did research with us. We gave him water infused with certain energy patterns, and he did research with germination of plants. And you can see how germination of group of these pinto beans is different when energy infused in the water in compared with control. They're healthier, stronger, faster growing, and so on. And we did even this kind of research with wheatgrass. You can see that this grown in healthy plant formula much stronger than in control. But what was interesting, that wheatgrass juice, which was made from it, had absolutely different taste than regular juice, wheatgrass juice. So it means that this energy pattern changed even biological biocontent of the wheat. Now, finally, we met scientists from Latvian University, Riga University, who suggested us to do research with our formula, which we call stress relief, in which they put just two drops of this stress relief into 250 milliliters of water. And mice were drinking this water for 9 days. And they made comparison using so-called open field test, which is standard pharmaceutical test for remedies, antidepressant remedies, anti-anxiety, and so on, this kind of remedies. And they made this test with using just this water with minerals infused with stress relief. Control mice were drinking the same minerals from the same bottle, but not infused with this energy. And you can visually see difference. This is the mice were moving, and video camera tracks them and shows how they move. And you can see that mice which were not drinking stress relief moves very differently from mice which were drinking stress relief. Because you can see that this central place, they try to be, you know, around, they don't want to go in open space, they are afraid, and some of them were stressed. They put them in the water, and mice, poor mice was swimming there for a while, not knowing if she or will be saved. And of course, it's stress. And they compared behavior of these stressed mice who were drinking or not drinking or drinking stress relief. And you can see a huge difference in their movement. And then they put graphs, of course. And there is, for instance, influence of stress relief energy pattern on time spent in central zone. You can see that these mice which were stressed but didn't drink stress relief were afraid to go in central zone. And 500% plus difference between mice who were drinking this. And the same with crossing zone, it's 500% difference. Mice which were drinking stress relief behaved totally differently. And there is no placebo in mice, as you know. But what was interesting, that they decided to also measure blood glucose level in these mice. And blood glucose level always raises when you are under stress. And this is the result. Control mice under stress had 30% raised glucose level. Mice which were drinking stress relief and were under stress had exactly the same glucose level as control group. Even that mice which were drinking stress relief but were not stressed also had, of course, normal blood glucose level. But the main thing that it showed that those mice which were stressed also had much better, much more stable glucose level. So then we asked some doctors to see, since we know that it influenced mice very well, do some research on people. And one doctor in Pennsylvania, his name is Jeffrey Marangel, he did literally thousands heart rate variability tests on people, and then combined his research, and that's what he says, how it influenced human being. He says, across the board, and regardless of category of conditions, consistent, repeatable responses were observed. Positive shifts were observed in most of the heart rate variability parameters, particularly in the relationship of the sympathetic to parasympathetic response. Shift in heart rate, myocardial response, high frequency, low frequency, which indicates balance between sympathetic and parasympathetic system, were observed. And total power, vascular compliance, and so on. A positive reaction in reserve power, vascular compliance, reserve capacity, and physical fitness measurements were seen consistently. Now, this is an example. In 15 minutes, parasympathetic response was changed. This is parasympathetic response, which is much worse than normal. Normal is in this range. And supine position and standing position, upright position and supine position are different response. When you give this person the same stress relief, in 15 minutes, this situation tremendously changed. Sympathetic, parasympathetic nervous system are balanced and they are in a range of normal functioning. So, is another example, I believe we have, right? Oh, no. Okay. It doesn't matter. It was thousands of them. I don't have time to show all of them. So, anyway, then we decided, okay, if it is really life force, it influences not only on systemic level, not only on our psychological level, but it should influence also on cellular level. Let's do research on cellular level. And this is research which was done in Beechtree Lab. It's on Rhode Island with human cells, skin cells. And they grew these cells in vitro in growth media not infused with energy patterns, and in growth media infused with different, in this case, four energy patterns. We call it peak performance for physical performance, stress relief, which I already mentioned, cells longevity, which was specifically created for support of cells, and anti-cancer energy. And you can see that all of them significantly overperformed control. And the best result, 180% plus vitality demonstrated by cells grown in the growth media infused with cells longevity, which was specifically created for cells. But what was interesting, after a while, these cells, of course, they eat all food and start dying in the tube. And after 8 days it start happening, cells start dying. And you can see from this that cells infused with this stress relief energy were dying much slower than control. And these two also demonstrated very good support for cells, even in this poisonous environment. When cells start dying, of course, it's very poisonous environment and the absence of food. Nevertheless, they were dying much slower than control. Which means that this energy, for instance, this stress relief, helps not only on systemic level, on sympathetic, parasympathetic level of human being, but even on the cellular level. So can you imagine how wide spectrum of effect this energy is? And of course, it demonstrates us one more time that this energy really earns the name vital force. And then we decided to go even further. If it's life force, it should influence gene expression also. It should affect us on genetic level. So we did, not we, but the same lab in Rhode Island, did research with genes. And it was shown that energy really affects genes expression. And what's interesting, we also wanted to ask to answer question, if you have regular remedy, chemical remedy, can be effect of this remedy enhanced by subtle energy. So this research was done with the remedy which is called M2, and this M2 is remedy for, they call it anti-aging remedy, and it also affects, among many other things, immune system. So these genes, mainly responsible for immune system response, and you can see that without, this is strong remedy, it changes activity of genes, particular genes, let's say, 16 times in compare with control. But if you infuse this remedy with energy, it goes to 26 times. Even this strong effect of M2 was enhanced. This was 7, 8, and it became 18. And what is interesting, that in two cases, in two genes, these genes were not affected by remedy itself. But when it is infused with the energy, it starts affecting these genes, this gene and this gene. One gene was down-regulated, which means its activity was diminished, which was not good in this case. And they didn't know how to help this. It was -4. When energy was added, it came back almost to normal. So it just demonstrates that energy not only influences activity of genes, but it also can help regular chemical remedies to work better, which opens, of course, enormous possibility for applications of subtle energy for in medicine, any kind of, any modalities of medicine. Thus we came to conclusion that now we see that subtle energy really affects our life on all levels, including the deepest level of the regulation of the biochemical processes in the body, genetic level. And as I already said, it's opened a totally new perspective for creation of tools for the integrative medicine. And there is a new area of science, as you know, which is called epigenetics, which says that environment influences us, but what mechanism of this environmental influence? Obviously, that if subtle energy, which is in environment, influences our genes, it opens possibility to answer this question, that subtle energy is at least one of the mechanisms which explain why environment influences us so strongly. That's all. Now, before asking question, let me suggest you the experiment. So how many of you know that you feel energy? Wow, great. Can we demonstrate you three energy patterns? They're recorded in our system. And this is one energy. It's energy created in different ways. Why? One is energy created by this generator. It's called Clear Mind. Oh, I would better not tell you what it does. Okay. Another energy is energy recorded on the nature. It's energy of nature. If you have been sometimes Yellowstone Park, there is a place which is called Fire Hole there, Fire Hole Waterfall. And the energy there is amazing. We recorded that energy and we put it in our equipment. And third one is energy created by human being, by healer. So we can demonstrate it. It can be, if it's too strong, we can regulate amount of energy coming out of these speakers. You will not hear anything. It's subtle energy. No sound. Don't expect it. So just try to feel it. 3 minutes? Each. Yeah, but we will probably stop. As soon as you feel it, raise your hands, and we will stop it. So that would be... Okay. Well, try to feel it. If it's not pleasant, tell me, because it can be too strong. We try to put pretty... Is okay? Too much? Too much? Mm-hmm. Hit. Okay, it's enough. Probably it's too strong for you, because it... Yeah, if you can diminish a little bit, yeah. Because we usually don't have many sensitive people in the audience, and we try to put it as much as possible to hit them. Yeah. Another one? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. It is nature.
What was the first one?
Clear mind. Right, because too strong, yeah. Feel, relax, uh-huh. Yeah, this is waterfall. Yeah, no? You're playing what? Third one? Oh, interesting. Okay.
That's, no,
let's make a short break, because it's too, you're mixing them in the room. Let's make a short break. Okay, one energy, I will tell you what, but about this, you know, strong influence, probably you heard about you know, system which is called Hemisync. Do you know who created it? Monroe is an incredible guy, and he could travel out of the body, and you know that, right? But he was not sensitive to energy, strangely enough. I came to his institute, and I played these energies that time. Long ago, it was much more primitive system, of course. And all his people felt it, but he didn't. And they said, you do something that Bob would feel it. And like in this case, I put it on full strength. And he said, what are you doing with my head? It hurts it. I said, they said, oh, he feels it, great. So, all right, third one. Feel it? Mm-hmm. So, is it okay? Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yeah. So, second one was birth trauma?
Healing trauma.
It was created by human being, by healer. It is healing trauma. And third one is waterfall. Yeah, third one, yeah. So it's a possibility. Third one was waterfall. I was wrong about second. And is still, yeah, still running. And third one was fire hole waterfall in Yellowstone. No, one waterfall in another healing trauma, which is just created by healer, by a healer. Mm-hmm. Relaxing. Mm-hmm. One more time? Yes. Okay. Let's heal our traumas.
Second one. You like it more? Healing trauma. It's like a birth trauma. It's usually it's healing traumas which were in childhood. Usually the childhood trauma healing. What? You know, ask people who feel it. Okay. not so strong. First one. Clear mind. It's. Good. Yeah. Oh no! Stop it! Ooh. Yeah. But it is really strong. But when you put 3 drops and drink it, it really clears the mind and helps very much. But yeah, it's not as pleasant as others. Ooh. Hey, too strong. Okay. So that's how it can be used. And some doctors say, oh no, you know, make a device and we will use it. And some people do subtle energy device, but you immediately feel what danger is in using devices of subtle energy. You affect everybody. Those people who are behind this wall also would be influenced. And you're not necessarily like you. You feel that it's not for you, and not now, at least, right? So you will influence hundreds of people, all your personal, and it's not a good idea. That's why we decided to infuse it and use it as a drops. It's individual. You don't influence other people, at least not as strong. Yes? You need a special computer, and it's not so easy, but it's possible, yeah. Now, questions. Yes, Beverly.
Could you say more about the process of your device? I'm thinking, you know, I know about the Russian torsion energy, and you mentioned scalar.
Don't use these words. They're not right. As I said, all these theories try to present subtle energy as a byproduct of electrical or interaction of spins or something else. But this is energy which is coming through substance of our three-dimensional world from another world, which is much more dimensional, and going through it and feeling, and I will be talking about it more tomorrow on workshop. It's like a feeling this space. There are some monopoles which drain this energy into our world and another from our world back. And it creates this flow of energy, like pool of energy around. And this energy creates four forces. You can read Philip's book and you will see that energy creates interaction between subquarks and quarks and creates this strong force and electrical charge and everything else. So this is primal force of the universe. All forces which we know is byproduct of it, not vice versa.
How do you stabilize your frequencies or your information in water? Because water is so easily influenced by many fields that are impinging on it all the time.
Yes. First of all, we use concentrated trace minerals. Yes, but it is like a 20% solution of minerals. It is strong. And what we found, the stronger content of minerals, the longer and more stable this energy is in it. Like if you infuse, let's say, distilled water, energy will dissipate in several days. Here, for 10 years, crystals, I will be talking about, I cannot talk about everything today, but we infused crystals, for instance, and we have data using heart rate, modern heart, there is a wonderful heart rate variability. I think, Beverly, you could be interested in it because this is really interesting device made by some doctor in Portland. And we observed dramatic changes in parameters of human body just wearing these crystals. How we found it, Dr. Nazarov accidentally, he measured this woman and she said, oh, by the way, I wear your crystals. He said, take it off. She took and suddenly her parameters changed dramatically. After that, he asked her to put back these crystals and her parameters came back to previous measurement. So just presence of this energy in your field, even not taking it inside, can dramatically influence our physiology, which confirms one more time that environment, if it's energetically strong, can very strongly affect us positively or negatively, depending on what kind of energy it is. And you felt it. Yeah.
I'm wondering if there's some kind of protection that we can buy for the cell phones.
Because yes, we do have.
You have it?
Yes.
How do I contact you to buy it?
We have it here.
Oh, you have it here?
Yeah.
Handy.
I don't know if you can, Mary, if you, we can bring it here and, because not everybody, I think, will do a workshop tomorrow.
I'm not going to be able to be here tomorrow, though. Can I buy it tonight?
Can we do it again?
After, we will bring it.
Okay. We have crystals for regulating chakras, for instance. Very, it's one of the crystals which was on that woman whom Igor measured. And they affect not just your feeling, but just physiology.
Right.
Some other questions?
I
want
to know where they're
from.
Oh.
Yes.
A crystal will affect your chakras whether or not you do anything to it. I mean, if you just put it in the sun, crystal is going to make your...
Of course. You can say, that's the same like you can say anything influences us. You can take a stone from the ground that will somehow influence. But difference is that if you want specifically affect you, for instance, you want to balance your chakra. Not all crystals will balance your chakra in such a way like you can compare using this heart rate variability, and you will see that difference is dramatic. If it's specifically created for balancing, it will balance much more effectively than any crystals which you can find.
Have you been able to measure the speed that this energy travels at? Is it like electromagnetic radiation at the speed of light, or is it?
You cannot. The problem is that you cannot measure with modern equipment this propagation. What was measured? The only what was measured? Propagation of it also was not measured, but at least it was demonstrated that propagation of this energy in human system. Like Beverly probably knows about Joy Jones' research with acupuncture, he influenced B67 point on the leg and measured response in the visual cortex here with MRI and found that it's at least several hundred times faster than any kind of neurological process in the body. Mm. But in the space, you don't have way to measure.
Real quickly, I don't know if this is in your area of exploration, but you know, HARP also puts out some pretty much consensus that it puts out energy. Is that
HARP?
You
mean HARP equipment, which is called HARP, or
yeah.
That system?
Yes.
So is that
you mean negative energy?
Yes. Can it be? And can the positive items that you have help mitigate that?
Unfortunately, we don't know because we didn't do this research. We need to have kind of the same, let's say, brain mapping measurement using our energy. We can create this energy. We can create, it sounds a little bit weird, but actually we can create energy for any purpose. But we need research. We, of course, you know, like shooting from the hip and hit right in the pen of target is difficult. you need to try and see, okay, then you adjust it until, like we did it with so-called AMM transformer, and until we reached the point when we really saw difference. So if we would have, as I said, just $1 million for for research, we would do it.
I'm having trouble with the, I don't know if it's the first vibration or the third vibration, it's right here, and I can't seem to get it off of me. Do you have it too? And I'm wondering...
It is probably the first one.
The first one?
Do you have clean suit?
Yes.
Do you have any suggestions?
We have energy which is used for cleaning energies from environment, and it was developed when we worked with Joy Jones. I didn't have time to talk about it. No,
it's right here. Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Does it help?
It moved. It's back here now instead of like right here. But
it's moved. Wow. That's not good scientific.
It's getting better.
Okay.
It's getting better.
Who else? You?
What's in that? Like, are there ions in there?
No, this is energy infused into this water. Water has very little potassium chloride, so it would be a little bit salty, but very little. Infused with this energy which cleans environment from negative if you wish energy.
Well, that would be related then, regardless of part, just how to mitigate.
Yeah, probably. Again, as I said, we need to research it. It is very possible, but we don't have proof. Yes,
I have used that spray. I'm a psychotherapist.
Really?
And I've used it for years. When I know that difficult couples are coming in, I spray before, I spray myself and afterwards. And I have given it to a friend of mine. She had a very anxious dog who would have separation anxiety, and she would spray the area before she would go shopping, and the dog would be sleeping while she was out.
Are you selling these things tonight?
Do we have?
I guess we do have like five or six screens.
Yeah,
but we have forms which you can fill and order through our website.
Yeah, we can give you all the information. Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any product that restores bones?
Restores bones? You know, we have energy for bone healing called, but we don't have research on it. We cannot swear that it works well. We know that it was created for, as I said, we have 5,000 already, 5,000 energetic patterns, and we don't have enough resources for research all of this. We are trying to research the most important energetic patterns, like for anxiety, for stress relief, depression, and heart support, oxygen, and so on and so on. Yes.
Very good, smooth, soft music is very good for people.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, yes. Of course, music, we know that music creates energetic effect. And it's possible to record energy on music. Absolutely. But, you know, it's unlimited possibilities, and we unfortunately have limited resources to research. Everything can be transferred into energy if you wish, and recorded and reproduced, and enhanced. But,
so you can get money attracting it, you can make money attracting it.
Oh, good idea!
About success and
achievement. Yeah, we have some energy which we call success and achievement. And I can tell you a very, very interesting story. One doctor worked with a child who was 8 months old, something like this. And child had some problem, and she tried everything possible, including our remedies, nothing helped. And suddenly she decided to try our meditative energy, which, of course, not for 8 months old child. And she found that this success and achievement energy is helping her, this girl. She gave her a couple of drops, and it tremendously helped her. Then she started asking what's going on in the family, and it appeared that father of this girl lost a job. And definitely father affected a daughter, and daughter, when she received the energy of success and achievement, felt better. It's amazing case when, you know, medical doctor wouldn't believe, of course.
Have you found a remedy for people with autism?
We are working with doctors who are researching autism. Very difficult case. We have, I would say, partial success. We can help them, but we cannot, we didn't find yet energy which really can cure them. But it's helped. We have several energies which are helpful for autistic children. They sleep better, they are much less anxious and so on. But to cure autism, again, we need just $1 million for research. I don't think that we would be supported for this kind of research.
No, you're not.
Yeah.
For alcohol abuse, alcoholism?
Yes, we have energy.
The crystal will work?
I don't know, we didn't try crystals, but we have energies which helped with different kind of addictions.
So how about menopause?
you know, strangely enough, we have energy which we are researching, we will be researching right now for it's not specifically for hot flashes, it's for hormonal balance. And it is strong, but again, we don't have yet research what exactly it's helpful for, like will it work for menopause or not. But it is strongly influences hormonal system, that we know. And we are looking forward to this research because it's a really important part.
You mentioned the EMF.
Yes.
Is there something to wear, or do you only have something to put on a cell phone?
Yes, on a cell phone. But no, we have crystals infused with this energy, yes. And that was one of the crystals which affected that girl, which was measured by either so strongly. She had two crystals, one for chakra cleansing, another for EMF protection. We call it protection, it's not the right word, but compensation, I would say, effect of EMF. Crystals? Yeah, I think we do, right?
I'm not sure about the EMF protection.
Yeah, I think we do several. Laura told me that.
Do you have a website where we can...
Yes, of course. Okay. Yes.
And
yes.
Also, that vibration, it can't hurt you, can it?
No, it will go away. You know, what is going on, if you have moving hip, you know what, it means that in your aura, there is something extraneous which is moving, and you, if you have good incense.
Incense?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Try incense. Try burn incense and put in this area, and even two or three, and try to balance your aura. It's possible that is what is going on. We had this kind of case when pain start moving. It means that there is something extraneous in your aura.
What is your website?
I can give you my
card. You can tell to anyone. You're
yeah, right.
We can.
You
can
tell to anyone.
Yeah. You
want to write it on something?
Yeah, yeah. Sure. So
on the board behind you? Or?
Oh, yeah. Do we have one?
Here she comes. Mm-hmm.
I'm involved in research on various solar energy projects over the mm-hmm. years. And,
yeah, I know.
You know, some of them operate very differently than yours. And most recently, you know, there's Luc Montagnier. Do you know his work?
Yes, I know.
Where you take the extremely high degrees. It's a sequence of DNA, and then you create a very potent dilution of that where there's no more DNA. Mm-hmm. And then you put it in a 7 hertz coil, and you broadcast that to pure water, and then later you can actually recreate the DNA.
Yes.
So this is operating very differently from yours. And then there are, you know, the scalar and
it's actually not. It's not actually differently. The only difference really between energies is information which you put in this energy. If you there should be different levels of energy. It's like to say that, you know, infrared is different from gamma rays. It's different by effect, but it's the same electromagnetic energy, right? So it's the same in the subtle energy. Subtle energy behavior depends very much on what and how you put information into it. And we can recreate the experiment.
Have you done that?
No, we don't. We actually, he already did it, why we need to do it? You know, it's interesting, of course, but we have limited time and only two of us. It will be pretty soon three and even we hope four, but still it's not enough. Yes. This is this is more about our research, vital force technology, and this is where you can find products. And for those who are professionals, they can call our office, get code for professional line, because we don't sell professional line to public. We just cannot. And through professionals, you can get anything we have. Beverly, as I said, I don't agree with these terms that and that energies. It's all the same energy fields of the universe, how we can handle them, how we can program them, direct them, it's a different story. And there are a lot of ways to do it, of course, you're right. And but energy which uses Montague used in his experiment. It's the same copying energy of DNA. We can copy it, no problem.
Right, you have a very different idea than his idea of nanions of water.
Oh, sure.
And your idea is dark energy.
But he doesn't.
How do you reconcile?
He just doesn't know about the existence of subtle energy, by the way. He tries to explain it with electromagnetic. But how you can explain that electromagnetic energy can be infused into it is not possible, right? So he just interprets his experiment, in my opinion, the wrong way, as many people, in terms of what is the carrier of this information. Carrier of this information is subtle energy. He just copied energy of DNA. And we can do it, as I said, no problem. Yep.
Yes. You can copy energies of various hormones, correct?
Right.
Like the menopause question. If there are energies that there are hormones that affect that.
Absolutely, we have a bunch of energies of hormones. But Jay, the problem is that you can then you will be acting like a regular medical doctor trying to infuse these symptoms or these symptoms just instead of chemicals with energy. Need to create energetic program which addresses the whole system instead of just trying to press one button and you don't know how it reflects on several others. And many, unfortunately, many doctors, even alternative doctors, doctors of energy medicine, they start using this like a medical doctor. Okay, this is a symptom, let's affect this symptom, but how it affects all others instead of Chinese approach. We influence this knowing that it's connected with that and that and that and that.
I agree.
That's what how subtle energy programs should be created.
Can you describe what you're going to teach tomorrow?
And if you can't come tomorrow, where are you? And when will you do another one? After you explain
where we are in Southern Oregon. We 6.5 hours drive from here. In Eagle Point. You will find all our data on this.
Is that Ashland?
We are close to Ashland. We are in Eagle Point, which is 25 minutes from Ashland.
What is it called?
Where
do you live? Where
Eagle Point. Eagle Point. It's, you know, Medford, Ashland. Ashland, almost everybody knows Ashland. It's like a, you know, like Sedona.
Ashland, yeah. Medford.
Right.
And Phoenix.
Yes, we are exactly right. And that we are on 62, just 12 miles from Medford.
Okay.
You're welcome to visit our, we will show you how we can infuse 55 gallon drums. Yeah, literally, it's not exaggeration. We can do it.
And then Mary's question about tomorrow?
Yeah, what will you be teaching us?
I want to speak, first of all, theoretical part, how energy interacts with substance. It's good to understand. When you understand that, Beverly, I think these questions about reconciliation would be answered. Because actually, as I said, it's effect like we don't know about existence of electromagnetic energy, and you see, oh, this energy influence so differently from this. This is heating, and this is, you know, penetrating your body and damaging your, but it's gamma rays and it's infrared, but it's still electromagnetic energy. It's the same, so more deep understanding how it works. It's first part. Second, more about our remedies and how, what they do, how we research that. I want to go in some more in details in the research and how we can demonstrate that it really works.
And will you demonstrate with us? Will you be doing some...
But this demonstrator, we already demonstrated.
Yeah,
but if you want some experiment with this substance, we can do it right on the spot. Yeah.
And you'll have the crystals tomorrow?
Yes, we have crystals, we have some products. Not many, but if somebody will need it, you always can reach us and we'll have all our forms. And and my cards, by the way, right here, I can give you all, everybody who wants them.
You can, right?
Yeah, right. But if you want, you can.
You need to know you use your product. How do you use the product? It sounds like you spray some.
Majority of products is just you put still drops in glass of water, let's say, and drink it. That's
how
it. It depends on professionals who measure. It needs to be under, of course, observation. Unless you just wear a crystal, you can wear as long as you want. But this average is 2-3 times a day, like 10 average dosages, 10 drops. But sometimes people, it's like for you it will too much energy, and 10 drops can be too much, you can diminish it up to 2, and then, I sweep it up.
Oh, please. I'm sorry.
No, it's a second.